Well, new findings from Northwestern Medicine indicates that pregnant women who were vaccinated for COVID-19 in the third trimester had a higher likelihood of passing antibodies to their newborn babies than women who received their vaccination a little closer to delivery. Joining us now to talk a little bit more about this, about the study, is Dr. Leena Mithal with Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Hello to you. Nice to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, so let's talk about this, because I think during this time when we're all kind of talking about the vaccine and the types of different vaccines, I think there's a lot of confusion and fear, particularly with pregnant women who may be thinking about it down the road. What is your study? What kind of insight does your study give them?
So our team focused on the question, are antibodies that mothers develop after COVID-19 vaccination during pregnancy transferred to the developing baby, and what factors might be associated with the efficiency of that transfer? So we looked at pregnant women, as you said, that had COVID-19 vaccine during pregnancy and delivered at Prentice Women's Hospital, and they delivered between January and March. So this was sort of an early study. And we looked at antibody levels in the mom and then in the umbilical cord blood, which reflects the infant antibody level. And we found two things. One, that women seem to have a robust immune response to vaccine and develop antibodies, which is important. And the secondly, that antibodies are transferred to baby. The new part of our study especially was that receiving two doses was associated with higher antibodies in the baby. And secondly, the earlier in the third trimester that you receive the vaccine, the more the longer the time between the first vaccine and the time of delivery, there was a higher level of transfer of antibodies to the baby.
So you're thinking the timing of when they receive the vaccine is really key in all of this. So you want to wait till the third trimester, or was it just you couldn't study earlier because, you know, the vaccine is something fairly new here that we're just now looking at?
Right. We didn't have women, just because of the timing of the study and vaccine availability of women that received it in first and second trimester, although we're following women and plan to follow those results moving forward. At this point, what we can say is among women that received vaccine throughout their third trimester, the earlier, the better in terms of third trimester and transfer of antibodies to the baby.
Makes perfect sense. Okay, I do want to turn to another thing that's been talked about very much here recently. There have been reports that some people are perhaps skipping the second dose of the vaccine, and the concern that you have as medical professionals about this.
Right, so the first dose of the vaccine induces the body's immune system to make a spike protein, which is part of the SARS-CoV-2 virus. The body then recognizes these proteins as foreign and develops an immune response. But part of the strength and the memory of this response comes from the second dose that leads to higher antibody levels in the recipient. And our efficacy data and most of the studies to date have really been reflecting that two-dose series. So at this point, it is really important to get both doses and in the recommended time frame for the vaccine that you're getting, in order to, you know, feel most confident that you have the protection that we feel the vaccine induces.
Yeah. Dr. Leena Mithal explaining all of this for us. Skipping that second dose, not an option. So thank you so much for clearing that up. We appreciate it.
Thank you.